Hello dear students, welcome back. We are here with another chemistry class. Today we are going to start a new lesson, nomenclature of organic compounds and isomerism. Don't get scared to hear such a big name. It will be very easy for you. This chapter focuses mainly about carbon and carbon compounds. Carbon is an element that is very familiar to you, right? Carbon is one of the elements present in nature both in elemental and combined state. The branch of chemistry deals with carbon and carbon compounds are called organic chemistry. In this lesson, we are going to study more about organic compounds. What are organic compounds? The carbon compounds except the inorganic compounds like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, carbonates, bicarbonates, etc. are known as organic compounds. Carbon forms numerous compounds in nature, right? Why carbon is able to form such a large number of compounds? The following characteristics are responsible for the increase in number of carbon compounds. Let's familiarize the structure of different types of organic compounds and the method of IUPAC nomenclature in this lesson. Look at the representations. What is the valency of carbon? The valency of carbon is 4, right? Imagine that the hydrogen atoms are added to these structures. How will be the structure? Isn't it like this? Now observe certain organic compounds and their molecular formulae. What are the characteristics of these compounds? Let's analyze. These compounds are called hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are compounds containing only carbon and hydrogen. These hydrocarbons can form compounds with single bond, double bond, and triple bond between the carbon atoms. Now observe the structures. These structures can also be written in condensed way, such as CH3 single bond CH3, CH2 double bond CH2, CH triple bond CH. Such representation is known as condensed formula. Examine the structure of the given compound. The number of carbon atom in this compound is 1. The number of hydrogen atom in this compound is 4. The molecular formula of this compound can be represented as CH4. See the next structure. Here the carbon atoms are united by the single bond, and the other three valencies of carbon are added by the hydrogen. The number of carbon atom in this compound is 2, and that of hydrogen is 6. So what will be the molecular formula? The molecular formula of this compound is C2H6. Let us see another structure with the 3 carbon atoms. What would be the structure and molecular formula of this compound? How many hydrogen atoms are required to satisfy all the valencies of carbon? The molecular formula of this compound is C3H8. Now compare the 3 structures that we discussed. Haven't you seen the single bond exists between all the carbon atoms? The open chain hydrocarbons having only single bond between the carbon atoms are called alkanes. In alkanes, as all the 4 valencies of each carbon atom are satisfied by single bonds, they are known as saturated hydrocarbons. So remember, alkanes are hydrocarbons with only single bond between the carbon atoms. So children, here is a worksheet for you. The structure of alkanes, its condensed formula and molecular formula are given. Complete the table and write it down on your notebook. Observe the given molecular formulae CH4, C2H6 and C3H8. What is the difference in the number of carbon and hydrogen atoms in two adjacent molecular formula? The difference in the number of carbon and hydrogen atom in the molecular formulae is CH2. The molecular formula of a hydrocarbon having 4 carbon atom is C4H10. The molecular formula of a hydrocarbon having 5 carbon atom is C5H12. Shall we deduce a general formula for the category alkane? What is the number of hydrogen atom in a hydrocarbon having 1 carbon atom? Yes, 4 hydrogen atoms, right? What is the number of hydrogen atom in a hydrocarbon having 2 carbon atom? Very good. It is 6. So what is the relation between the number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen in alkane? The number of hydrogen is got by adding 2 to the double of the number of carbon atoms. Got it? Could you tell me how many hydrogen atoms will be required for a hydrocarbon with a 3 carbon atom? Is it 8? Here also, we get the number of hydrogen by adding 2 to the double of the carbon atom. Now, did you understand? Hence, in an alkane having n carbon atoms, the number of hydrogen atoms will be 2n plus 2. The general formula for alkanes can be represented as CnH2n plus 2. So what is the general formula? Remember, the general formula of alkane is CnH2n plus 2. So children, we saw that there exists a CH2 difference between any two successive alkanes, right? Such series of compounds are known by the name homologous series. So what are homologous series? Homologous series are compounds in which if any two consecutive members of the series differ in their molecular formula by a CH2 group is called a homologous series. The homologous series will show the following characteristics. The members of the series can be represented by a general formula. The successive members will differ by a CH2 group. Moreover, these series will show a similar chemical properties and a regular gradation in their physical properties. Got it, children? Okay, it's the time to wind up today's class. See you in the next class, children. Thank you.